What's going on, guys? Vic VP back with another Game Case Arcade video. Today we're going to be talking about the Pandora's Box 3D. I figure it's much better for me to screen capture it. Unfortunately, my monitor doesn't have any sound coming out of it because it's a monitor. So just give you a heads up as far as headphone people. I don't know if I'm loud. I don't know if the audio coming out of the Elgato is going to be loud. So just get ready for that. I haven't really seen any videos on the Pandora's Box 3D, so I figured this is the perfect time to do it. So what I'm basically going to do real quick is I'm actually going to power it on. Again, I am using Eugene's control panel that's on my lap. You guys don't see it, but basically I'm going to power it on and we're going to see how it goes. Let's first get the power on and here we go. Again, I'm making this video because I don't really think, I haven't seen any video on it. Again, this is the Pandora's Box 3D. Pretty mind-blown by it. So, you know, for it to play PSP games and all that, I was pretty shocked by it. So, this is a little boot screen. I'm going to take my webcam out so you can see the whole thing. And like I said, this basically is, I'm attached via HDMI. This does have a VGA input on it, so you could put, like, you know, the old school monitor on it. But this does push 16 by 9. I don't know if there's any settings to it. Which actually, I could actually enable the settings mode real quick. Let's take a look at that real quick as far as test mode on that. So on the PCB itself, there we go. We literally have the test mode here. We set it to free play. You know, one coin equals two credits, or nine coins equals one credit. Your exit mode is usually start and coin. I did find another way, which I'll show you guys that, which is basically on player two coin. I have that set up. Auto exit after 3 minutes. This is not being used. Image optimization. So you have HD and then you also have scanline. I didn't try this. I'd rather just keep it as HD. Burst settings. I guess in case you were playing like Galaga, you could always hold down the button. I'm going to keep that disabled for now. I mean, that's really it. If I do enter game too many settings, I really don't want to play around with this too much, but there you go. We're going to exit out account management, clear coins, reset password. Again, we do have, somebody did message me, this is the JAMA version. This is not the home edition. Apparently the home edition, you could possibly have Wi-Fi. Somebody did send me a picture of it. That's cool, but for right now, we are running the JAMA version. Figure for the first thing right now, let's just go down the list as far as games. On your left side, you can literally see the PlayStation kind of D-pad. This is actually PSP. So I'm not going to like, I'll go slowly. I'm not going to name everything down. This does have Dreamcast. This is PlayStation 1. You do have N64 games. Again, if you do want to like see the actual list, I'm just going to go down. You know, if you want to pause the video and you'll see what games are on it, that's easier, or else this video is just going to be too long for no reason. A lot of N64 games, I'm pretty surprised, but again, playing on an arcade stick, the F is Final Burn Alpha. So this is basically a version of MAME Arcade. M is MAME. Basically in this kind of list where I'm under all, I don't know if this is alphabetical order. Let's see. Elemental P, QRS. I think they have this set up as like fighting first. Again, I'm just going down just so you guys could kind of see what games are on it. Again, right now we are in the arcade. I'm still under all. I'll go by category just so you can see that. But this does have around 2,000 games to it. Let me see if I hold down. There you go. I'm just going to do this, guys. This way you could... Oh, okay. Can't do that. It looks like in this all category, it's separating it by genres. So now we have all the shooters. Basically, these are really shoot-em-ups, shmups. Again, I don't want to take this video too long. I didn't want to record it like a regular video. I just figure... I'm going to do the Elgato capture and then you guys can see it from there. I again, 233 pages. It's a lot of games. I did find a couple of duplicates, basically meaning by that, like, especially when it came to Street Fighter, you're literally going to see a lot of, like, you know, Street Fighter, you know, World Warrior. There's like four different versions of it. You know, I don't know. Bang Bang Bus, is this Bow Rose? No, that's not. Again, some of the classic stuff. Pretty cool. The thing about like the video previews, I think it's only 10 seconds long. And there's no audio apparently coming out of the preview, which kind of sucks. Especially when it comes to like a track mode, there is no audio coming out of that. So yes, this is in alphabetical order, but by system genre. There is a search, as you can see. There is a search bar showing. Again, I disabled my webcam so you guys could see the entire list. So now we're getting mixed up with different genres. This is in alphabetical order. This again, though, is showing all the games. So, you know, we could at least see what's happening. Again, right now, this is mostly arcade. So Final Burn Alpha and MAME Arcade. Again, I am live streaming this. So you guys, when you go back, this will be saved on my whole video setup. And you guys will be able to go back and see, you know, the whole list, really. It's just for me to sit through here for 2,000 games showing you previews. It's kind of dumb. But I've yet really to find, like, a good list. There's no real list. I'll attach in the description below where we purchased this from. Again, customer Eugene wanted this in his, I wonder if that's a four-player version or a two-player. But it's okay. It's under Simpsons, not The Simpsons. Again, just kind of going through it. This is really meant for, you know, arcade stuff. But the real reason I'm making this is because, look at this. So there is, see, we have three different versions of The Simpsons. It looks like they do have the four-player version and the two-player. Again, I've literally sat and I haven't seen a video really showing the list on this, even like the documentation, which kind of sucks with these. Again, this is not a real Pandora's box, meaning I don't think it's made by 3A, the real Pandora's box company. These are considered clones. So again, as you can see on the top right, this is a Pandora's Games 3D. Again, we're still in like the MAM. We're at Z now, we're back at A. So again, this all, literally this all list is just kind of sporadic, but now like you can see we're under puzzles. You can tell by the logo on the right. We're gonna load up a couple of games. But most importantly, I mean, again, everybody knows arcade. Arcade is arcade. I'll try to run Golden Axe. I'll try to see if there is, I'm pretty sure there is Metal Slug. I will see, Eugene just texted me. He does want me to see if I could enable blood mode like we did with the Pi. This now we're on the sports. Hit the ice. I doubt like 2-on-2. NBA Jam. Interesting. Interesting. This does have NBA Jam. That's the games that I'm going to definitely try to check out because that's honestly most of the games that people do want to play. We're going to see if NBA Jam. Again, unfortunately, I don't have the audio. I don't have my headphones hooked up to it because I'd rather you guys hear the audio than me. But yeah, we're going to just keep going. We're almost there. Again, this beginning of it is really just for you guys to see all the games. What's this, like Toy Story? Interesting. This is a... Oh, when did I play this? This is like an NES game. That's an NES to Super NES game, honestly. That's the original Toy Story. That's a classic game. Interesting. Centipede. I mean, Centipede is Centipede. Galaga. Ghosts and Goblins. See, now, like, at the bottom of this list, it has, like, an actual nice list. Marvel vs. Capcom. And again, this does have Marvel vs. Capcom 2 under the Sega Dreamcast, which does play pretty well. You're going to see a closing video for Eugene's arcade control panel coming up where I did kind of show off that. No lag, apparently, on that. So as far as the Pi 3, this does kick the Pi 3's butt. Again, we're almost there. Again, as you can see, like, I don't know what kind of order this is in. Mario Bros. US. That's like a new thing. I mean, I remember about 6 months ago, Mario Bros. Was on like the Pandoras box, like six or seven that I installed on someone. So that was a shocker. Almost there. I think it was 2,300 games on this. Simpsons Bowling. That's not Simpsons Bowling. We're gonna have to load this up to see that. I gotta make a list. Again, I didn't prepare myself, but we are kind of looking at games that. That's the VS version, okay. Looking at games that are very like shocking to see, but again, we could kind of see that there are a couple of duplicates. Let's see, WWF Superstars. That's a classic. I noticed that there's no WrestleMania. TMNT. We got both TMNTs, but these look like four-player versions. Growl, interesting. That was the Famicom. This image on the left is Famicom. There is also the Super Famicom on this. There is Game Boy Advance, which we'll take a look at everything a little bit. I don't want this video to be too long, but this is the Game Boy Advance side. Luckily, honestly, I do see customers using mostly the category list on this. Again, I did actually let this run for 48 hours straight. It didn't reboot. It didn't turn off. That's what I usually do for JAMA-based systems. I always let it run overnight. Unfortunately, this attract mode, I don't know if it's because it is in coin mode, free play mode, but I'm gonna play around with it on the stream now. This is the Super Nintendo. Basically, we're gonna see what happens if we enable coin mode, and we'll see. Here we go. Let's see. WWF Royal Wrestling. It's Royal Rumble, really. Crazy Wrestling? No, this is not the name of the game, but as you can see, this is kind of the hard part with these knockoffs. Kings of Valor. So 2323. I'm at the end of the list right now. So again, if you want to see the game list, there you have it. Unfortunately, now, so there is a page thing. Okay, we're up. We'll go to category. So as you can see on the category, right at the bottom, underneath the word Loco Roco, you can see it. This is running the PP, SSPP. This is the PSP emulator. There's 10 PSP games. We have two, four, six PlayStation games. This is PS1, N64. I'm not going to count it all, but a good amount. This is the Famicom. We have seven pages. And there's what? Two, four, six, eight. There's 10. So it's 70. This right here probably has 40 Super Nintendo games. Again, very interesting. Game Boy Advance, we probably have 30. I'm saying that with the page on the bottom right, you can see three out of three. 10 times three is 30. Looks like there's 20 Game Boy Advance games. And we'll load up a game on each and we'll see how it goes. Mega Drive, I believe, is the MD. This is about 20 games. PCE, two, four, six. You got eight games. I'll be honest, I don't really recognize the system. I don't know all my systems. We got four Dreamcasts, and this is the funny one here. This is Cartoon Hero versus Capcom 2. Unfortunately, it's not Cartoon Hero, it's Capcom, but this is kind of the thing that kind of sucks when you want to actually search up a game. This is actually Marvel versus Capcom, I'm sorry. So this is Cartoon Hero versus Capcom. You get instances like that. Final Burn Alpha, that's 1,370 games. Again, this is considered arcade. We do have our Metal Slug. We are going to load that up probably first just to see if we could get blood mode enabled. MAME, you got 690 MAME arcades. And I mean, I haven't really sat down and seen if there's any duplicates. But as you can see, like we already have three champion editions. Eugene did want the World Warrior version. I didn't add games to this. This came with games preloaded. And there we have it. So we have everything here. If we do the search bar, it's set to hold one. And as you can see, you could do a little bit of a search. Let's do real quick. So button one, again, I do have a six button layout. I do want to look up Metal Slug just for the first part of it. And we are going to see one button loads it up. Now again, this is at the free play, so I don't know if this automatically adds a credit, but we're gonna press player one. Player one coin adds coin. Player two start. As you can see, I'm also adding credits on player two start as a combination of coins and player two. So I do have two players, but real unique thing, player two coin brings up this. You do have the option to continue exit, save state, and load state. So this does give you the option to save a state. I just pressed save a state. Let's see if we can load a state. I did. It did actually load the state exactly where we are. So player one holding down the start button. This should enable the dip switches, and no, we cannot get the blood mode on this. And again, as you can see on my pie video, we're going to try player two start. No, we cannot enable blood mode on it. I'm just going to basically try to run through this. Hilton, bro, what's up, man? Hilton, awesome dude. He's constantly commenting and checking out my videos. I appreciate it, bro. We are checking out right now the Pandora's Box 3D. I just want to try to really see if there's any lag to it. Which again, I mean, this isn't the pie. Again, this is kind of hard playing with one. No. One person, two characters. Lost our stuff. But again, I don't know how loud it is. I don't have audio coming out of this monitor. And I don't want button matching really to be on the microphone, to be honest. But there we go. Metal Slug, at least for right now. This is a Pandora's Box. We're going to exit out. So I'm going to hit player two coin. And I'm going to actually, you know what? Before we do that, let me save state. Let's test out the load. If I can, let me actually drop the coin. Let's test out the load again. Yes. Okay, so now let's exit the game. Let's go back into Metal Slug real quick. And we're going to see, can we load where we were? Yes. Okay, cool. So this does save states. That's pretty awesome. Let's exit out. I'm going to do one more Metal Slug just to see if I can enable blood mode. Unfortunately, doesn't look too good right now. I'm holding down player one start, and I am getting nothing. Let's do coin. Player one start and coin. Nothing. So as you can see right now, I'm pressing player one start, and you can see the credits at the bottom. They just keep adding. I mean, again, I know that when I did the test, and I'll actually load up the testing real quick, you'll actually see that some of their buttons are set to both. It's very odd. Okay, so Metal Slug didn't work as far as the blood mode. We did see real quick Simpsons Bowling. Let's load that up. So S-I-M-P. Simpsons Bowling. So let's see Simpsons Bowling. Let's all get disappointed real quick. Ooh, long loading screen on this one. Maybe it will, I don't know. But then again, this control panel doesn't have the option for trackball. Unless you could enable trackball via USB. No. Okay, and it did all four players apparently. I don't know how that happened. I didn't even do it. But as you can see, this is not Simpsons Bowling. Let's load it up right now because it literally put four coins in. Let's just see, they might have it set up as player one and player three. No, okay, player one and two. So this is correct. You're A-okay. The big thing is, I guess, with player three and four, you know, how can we get that to work? Some games right now, you can see it, this does not have the load or the save state. Am I in MAME on this? I am in MAME, MAME Arcade. So let's see Simpsons Final Burn Alpha. Loading on that was quick. This is still the four-player version, and we do have the save state. So again, a customer might not understand what that means. It's basically two different emulators. And right now I'm looking for, this is a four-player one. So let's exit out again. Let's see if the two-player version of MAME, so this version will not give you the save state. Look at that loading time on that MAME arcade. As you can see, the loading bar, it's loading. So let's let that rock. Okay, let's see. Will this give us a two-player version? No. Oh, I'm sorry, it is. Oh, I'm an idiot. Okay, so we do have the two-player version. Let me actually go back. That was my mistake. Let's go back to the Simpsons 1. So two-player version is good. This is actually the preview of it. I'm sorry, yes, okay. This is the two-player version. Sorry, every time I see the four characters come up, I thought it was the four player, but no, this is good. So as you can see, negative on that for Simpsons Bowling. What else do we want to try? NBA Jam, I did see that. Let's bring that up. Again, I am literally winging this. Oh, and I just saw Blitz. I saw Blitz somewhere. NBA Jam, Mame Arcade, let's see. Four-player mod, two-player mod, let's just see how it plays. Again, unfortunately, I don't have audio. Again, it looks like it adds coins. Let's see.
NBA Jam.
Okay, this is the one downside for these. At least some people don't understand how the emulators are set up. So basically, this right now is set up as player one and two. We are on the same team. Nobody wants to play that. We want to play against Lakers. Each other. And that is the one thing that kind of sucks. You do usually want to play against each other. So, such as the Pi or PC build, you know, you will be able to set up what player one and two is. So really with this kind of game, it really should be player one is player one and player two is really player three. Same goes for like 2-on-2, NFL Blitz. Let's just see.
God.
I'm trying to figure out real quick. See, this would be awesome to test if I was playing against an actual, you know, person. Let's see. So this is a three-button game. So we have... Okay, hello. Okay, so we are using buttons 1, 2, and 3 for this. At least get that working. So we have an option to save state. No. NBA Jam. Four-player version. That kind of sucked, to be honest, because we want to play against each other. I don't have a keyboard hooked up to this. I don't know if you could tab. I'm not going to really look at that because I really don't care because that's just too much work. I did see the word Blitz pop up. Let's see what that is. NFL Blitz on the N64. And we are going to touch up on a couple of these, like, you know, N64, PSP. Again, I'm really making this because I was mind blown by the PSP. Again, NFL Blitz, you're talking about right now using an N64 controller on the arcade stick. Controller pack, even for controller. So player two start. Okay, we're in. I'm just going to use the same team. I really don't care. So again, I mean, I never played this on the N64. The N64, you're talking about 6, 7, 8, 9 buttons on the N64. The arcade version of NFL Blitz was a three-button game, I believe. Let's just see real quick what's happening. Okay, so button one and two so far. Let's see what button one does. Controller info, I should have read that, but whatever, because you can't really tell what it is. So I'm pressing a page. I'm just trying to pick a play. And I didn't even pick a play. Shit. Okay, again, we're still button mashing, still with chill, trying to figure out everything. Okay, if I want to do this, button one, button two flips, button three, four, five, six. Nothing on this. Oh, maybe it's button A? I'm not sure. Let's just see. Okay, button one, looks like it's my A button. I am throwing the ball. A. Okay, so yes, button one is our A. I'm right now just running. Can I run? Let's see. I mean, so far, seems all right. I mean, can't really complain. Trying to figure out how to run. Just got body slammed to hell. Because usually on the arcade version, like the running, you would actually see your player's feet. Nothing with it. Nothing. It used to be a turbo, like you would be able to run. Let's do one more pass. Let's see how that goes. There we go. Okay, not too bad. Second goal. Not bad. I mean, as of right now, I mean, literally running N64. Oh, God. Running N64 on a Pandora's box, I would never imagine this day would come. But there you have it. There's a touchdown right there. Again, we are doing button two. Not too bad, right? I mean, so far, so good. Pretty cool. Let's do now, like, let's go system by system real quick, because again, some of these games did blow my mind. I mean, we're talking Tekken 6. The real thing that surprised me, honestly, was, well, this is a PSP game. I'm going to show you this real quick. You guys can't see it, but I'm right now going to, this is a PSP. So PSP is usually a one-player like system. It's a handheld. I'm going to press player 2 now and watch this. I'm literally going to press player 2. Not, I'm going to have my hands up. I'll put it even on the webcam if you guys want. So I'm going to press player 2. Look at this. It somehow now is enabling LAN mode, which is like wireless mode. Again, it's doing it by itself. Like it finds player 2. I'm not pressing anything. And like now we're versing each other, which is this to me, it blew my mind.
Like, Raven, like Jin Kazama.
I was literally there like, what? And I didn't really expect it. I pressed player 2 and all of a sudden we are in a match.
Get ready for the next match.
I cannot disable that apparently. It might say it real quick.
Round 1.
When I tested this on the video on YouTube, I didn't have a monitor that said audio. Can be turned off in game settings. This game supports double play, but does not support archiving. Press player to start double to enter double mode. Oh, well, we did that. So like I said, we just press player to start, and we're in it. So again, the one thing about Tekken is like, you have to actually practice your moving. You'd actually have to
You
hit.
Lose.
I mean, again, PSP right now, Round on a two. Bot. I mean, mind-boggling stuff. I would never expect that. I am not a Tekken player, don't know Tekken too much, I don't know their button combos, but right now, if I do player 2, player 1 start, player 1 point, no, so now it's like it's all about like trying to figure out how to exit. I mean, that's exit the system console, but right now let me just beat this up.
You lose!
Like, this right now I can't press start, I can't like exit this fight. Real quick, again, I am not a... See, now I'm exiting. I guess it's gonna be like... Yeah, see, now it's like disconnecting and all that. Disconnected. I'm trying to like... That's another thing. Again, we are using arcade stick. You know, we have to figure out and learn what is what button. So button 1 right now is like X. Again, I don't play Tekken. Really unique character because
get ready for the next
tiger head on a man is kind of interesting, but let's see.
Round
again,
one.
Running a PSP game, we are playing a computer now. I'm gonna mute my mic.
Win. Round 2. Fight.
All right, let's have a match thing. Again, Tekken, PSP, we do have Mortal Kombat. I'm going to load that up and I'm going to do WWE All-Stars. Again, I didn't have audio for the All-Stars, because of the monitor I was using in the video, but, I mean, again, it's very crazy, like, literally, same thing, if I put, let me actually do real quick, let's do a quick, arcade, kind of just, game with computer real quick, so you can see that. Sub-Zero, why not? Same thing, I'm not a Mortal Kombat player, so I don't know any of the specials or anything like that. Okay, then I'm gonna go sound on mic.
Round 1. Fight! flawless victory.
There you have it. Of course, I don't know fatalities, but I mean, I can't tell from the audio. I'll take a look later on at the video when it uploads.
Round one.
But again, I mean, I can't tell if there's any stuttering going on, really. I muted my mic so I don't hear a bunch of fun matching that I'm doing, because, again, I am not a Mortal Kombat player. Trying to pull up, like, a Hadouken round. Don't know what I just did, but okay. But, I mean, again, as far as, like, gameplay-wise, it's pretty smooth. Same thing, you can press player 2 start, and it literally, like, enables... It does it by itself. It goes into, like, the Wi-Fi mode, and it's crazy. Again, player 2 coin brings up this menu. We're going to exit. Let's check out real quick the WWE All-Stars. I noticed this definitely has lag on us. Again, look at the slow time. Keep that also in mind. We literally have a quick load time. So C, circle is button 4 on the arcade stick. I mean, let's just see if we can play like that. Boston. Now, I did not press player 2 start. And again, it's kind of like I'm hoping.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Friday Night Smackdown.
Maybe in the actual beam. Again, I don't know what the audio sounds like coming out of this. I just want to get into the actual fighting because, again, I definitely noticed the stuttering and all that.
And his opponent making his way down the ramp.
Same thing, I'm going to turn off my microphone and...
And there's the sound we've been waiting for. Here we go. I have never felt an excitement level like this before in my life. This is going to be the most anticipated match in the history of sports entertainment. Off the ropes, what agility. I'm always amazed at the ability it takes to pull off something like that. Oh, what a beautiful textbook suplex. Scoop slam. Oh, that was a game changer. Goes down face first. Knocks him off balance. He's got him staggering now. The tried and true headlock.
Like right now, trying to get a weapon.
Spinning neck breakers, folks. Wow.
Just trying to get a weapon right now. And again, I never played this game before. I'm right now trying to get
to
up onto the ring.
Ouch. Moved his attention to the midsection. Look at him go.
This is like the one thing. See, this, I don't know if this game is utilizing the D-pad. And, okay, I'm in the ring at least. I don't know how I got in. I mean, again, I might be utilizing the D-pad and the analog stick. Again, that is the PSP. PSP had two sticks. And that's what
the
hard thing to do. What the hell? People don't understand that when it comes to arcade sticks, you can't play every system with the arcade stick. I'm getting my ass handed to me, but to charge up a strike. I mean, luckily it's trying to give me some dip.
He's simply trying
I just
to stay on his feet after
like,
that.
Can I
his
do
legs are wobbly.
Keep doing the same move. But I mean, again, when I was playing like two-player, it was lagging. I can't tell right now how the audio is. It looks like in slow motion. Like this right now is running to me in slow motion. He literally is gonna kick my ass right now. Oh my god.
Now that's
I mean, it's a cool game. Can't
He's
lie.
Leaving
like,
it all
like,
out here tonight.
I can't tell what this game reminds me of, but like, it's cool. I mean, it's a cool game. Again, I can't tell if the audio is slow. To me, I think the gameplay is running slow on this. It's not like Mortal Kombat. But there you have it. Let's exit out. You're gonna get a lot of stuff. Dragon Ball Z was a game that was in Chinese. It was literally, I'll load it up real quick. It was in tongue. It was some type of Asian lettering. I couldn't even understand what to do. So, I mean, if I do this, that's great. And this is it. This, again, this is a PSP menu right here. This is literally loading up the save state. It is using the PPSSPP emulator. See, now this is where I just got lost. So, yeah. But again, it's really interesting. I mean, a Pandora's box playing PSP. I mean, that's nuts. Player 2 coin. This does have save states, apparently. I don't care right now. We're exiting. PlayStation. Let's see. We'll do maybe Tekken. I'd rather do a graphic intense game just to really see how it is. Again, no, like, not many loading screens. Like, the Dreamcast had the Dreamcast loading screen on it. Let's see. Might as well load up Eddie Gordo. Oh, I should have been Eddie Gordo. Eddie Gordo is classic. I've played this on the actual arcade, so this is really an arcade cabinet type game,
Round
but it is
one,
running off of the
fight.
PlayStation emulator. It's sort of a great dance move and everything. So, I mean, let's just see real quick. Let me. Can I exit? Okay. Let's go arcade. And I will just be myself against the computer. Again, I'll mute the mic so we don't hear button mashing.
Round one, fight.
Notice Tekken on the arcade. This is a 4-button game, so I'm using a 6-button layout on an arcade control panel. So it is using buttons 1, 2, 3, and 4. So it's very unusual to play like this. And again, I am not a Tekken pro, but like right now, I'm using buttons 1, 2, 3, and 4. So that's the whole top row and the first button on the second row. So I mean, again, that's what kind of sucks. Unless you're gonna make a dedicated Tekken cabinet, you'll make it accordingly. But there you have it. Checked it out. Cause I already see I'm in 30 minutes on this. I did want to show like GoldenEye. Okay, this was very interesting. Especially seeing this compared to like the Raspberry Pi build. Like on a Pi 3B Plus. Again, I am using arcade sticks to play this right now. This was shocking though. Honestly, this ran smooth. There is a couple of like graphic things you could see. You might see a couple of lines on the screen, which I don't think is a big deal breaker. But it ran. Like I literally, again, unfortunately, when I first did the video on this, I didn't have a monitor with speakers on it, so I couldn't hear anything. But right now, again, keep in mind I am using an arcade stick to play. That's great. Shot at real quick. Trying to learn the button. Okay, hello. Nope. Okay, here we go. So we are using button 5. Again, very clear that you cannot use arcade sticks for Tekken, for GoldenEye or many games. I know for a fact, like, even if I run straight, like, on the Raspberry Pi, like, I would be lagging. I did not get this far. I don't know how the sound is going to be. And there you have it. So again, I mean, it was mind-boggling stuff. This did have Tony Hawk. It did have Toy Story. Like, I was very surprised by that. But again, these are the types of games you really need, unless they really did take games out. I played Bastender as a kid, and that game sucked. And unless you take like the actual, like maybe they put games that only use 6 buttons. Wow, Rampage 2 Universal Tour. Oh, Paperboy. This is the 3D version. This game sucked. That was a pain in the ass to play. Super Mario 64. You even have Super Smash Bros, which you could play two players on the arcade sticks. It wasn't comfortable, but it was doable. But I did want to see, like, let's do Tony Hawk's real quick. I mean, I know I tried Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 2 on the Pi, and same thing, you just get lag. It is laggy, but I mean, again, just to see this playing on a knockoff Pandora's box, you know, it's literally running an emulator in the back. I'm guessing it's running Project 64. That is really the emulator that I know of. I use that for all my builds, especially with the hyperspin build. I know I'm not going to be able to complete tricks. I know that for sure, because again, you do need a controller for this. I mean, but as you can see, like, right now, I can't bend my knee. So, like, this is the one thing, like, I can't jump. Like I said, see, you can't play this game with the arcade stand, but check it out. Let's do real quick. Somebody's going to be mad that I didn't do it, but let's try Super Smash Bros. Real quick. Again, N64 version of Super Smash Bros. Oh, I didn't want to do one player game. Bring it back. Oh, crap. Again, I'm pretty sure, like, if it could run this, I'm pretty sure it could run the Game Boy Advance games and all that very easily. Super Famicom, I'm pretty sure it could run that, because let's be real. I mean, those games are all, like, just 2D, they're not 3D. But, again, just looking at the Elgato sound meter, I just know, like, I won't be able to do it much. It's like a taunt, so like, I don't know what that is. I'm guessing that's how. Again, using arcade sticks to play this is a nightmare. But, you get the hint of it. Exit out. Let's go. Like Toy Story? Like, did you see that? It had Toy Story on it. I'm pretty sure it'll play this. I'm very sure it'll play the Super Nintendo. Let's just see if we have Super Nintendo, let's just see, Super Mario and Mario. WWF Crazy Wrestling. This is classic. I used to love this game as a kid. Hitting people with the chair was hilarious to me. Let's just see what happens when we load up Super Mario. Is this like All-Stars? As you can see, we do have Asian Light. Okay, so this is All-Stars. Okay. Now, okay, so pressing start, that brings this up. I mean, some people don't care. I mean, it's just wording, but so okay. Apparently, I do have that. Let's see. So, what do we got? Button one is to jump, and button two is to jump. I'm pretty sure button four will let me run. Yeah, so button one and two is to jump. Button one is like a turbo jump. Is it turbo or is it two? Nope, none of them. But as you can see right now, we are literally playing Super Mario World 3 All-Stars. There you go. Let's see. Do we have a save state? We do. We do have the option to save state. So pretty cool. Game Boy Advance. Again, I don't think they're going to be in English. Let's just see. I went back to Super Nintendo by accident. Somebody's going to probably want Mario Party. Interesting. You could even see in the preview. Somebody's gonna want Pokemon. Let's see what Pokemon looks like. But again, listen, I'm really making this because when I saw the game list, I was like, what? On a Pandora's box? Like, are you sure? And yeah. So kudos to you if you could read this. That's amazing. But I'm pretty sure this will play very fine. Let's make it out. Game Boy Advance. Yeah, we even have the Mega Drive. Look at that. Bozzy. That's Bart's. Bozzy's White Nightmare. That's Bart's worst nightmare, or it's a Simpsons game. That's you got to be careful of. Again, you got to expect that. I mean, listen, that's what happens. What is that? Street Tyrant 2. Interesting. I just saw... What? Interesting. This is like a Ninja Turtles Street Fighter edition. I have to load this up now. Let's see what this is. Tournament Fighters? This is a Sega game. Okay. TMNT Tournament Fighters. Interesting. And how do we pick someone? Start. Start button. Let's rock. I haven't seen the screen on my Elgato spazzing. I press start on player 2. Yeah, this works. Interesting. This, I don't even want to. This doesn't even want to. I don't want to play any of these. Next. Oh, yes. Okay, here we go. So we are going to do real quick Marvel vs. Capcom 2. I've played this on the Raspberry Pi. So on the Dreamcast here, this does not go to 16:9. But it does load up the Dreamcast. I'm guessing this is Demuel as an emulator. I'm going to breeze across it. And I think this will be the last game that we're going to test, as this stream went into 45 minutes. Marvel. I mean, again, though, I got customers that want like the Pandora's Box 6, and they, you know, they want it easy. But for you to know that you could play these games on a Pandora's Box, it's very interesting. Again, I don't know why my Elgato is spazzing out. I see it on my OBS stream, kind of bouncing. I don't know if you guys are getting that, but on my actual monitor, I don't see this bouncing going on. I wouldn't stress that too much. So here we go. You can kind of see the lines on my cable. Again, I will mute. So I'm just trying to pull up like some super combos so that you can see like there is no lag. It just kind of sucks playing this kind of stuff on an arcade stick because you don't know what buttons it is. As you can see with cable shooting, on the arcade it was button 1, but on this it is button 5 for like your standard punch. And again, it's taking the Dreamcast version, so I'm guessing button 5 and 6 are the shoulder buttons. As you can see, I'm calling in my teammate, whereas the arcade version, like, you press the 2 middle kick and middle punch to bring in your character. And like I said, right now, I'm button mashing the hell out of this just to get the players to come out and do the super button. As you can see, definitely as far as a Raspberry Pi, this is not lagging. And it's actually pretty enjoyable once you figure out your buttons and all that, but I just want to unleash a super and I can't. So great. We're going to exit out. And that's really it, guys. I mean, again, you do have your basics. Again, you do see some duplicates. Let's do that real quick for you guys. See, like, you have Street Fighter 2 Championship Editions, Hyper Fighting. You actually have 4 Championship Editions. And as you can see, if you were going to search Street Fighter, you would have to put SF. You can't put Street Fighter. You got to put SF. So stuff you got to, like, really try. Let's see. Eugene did want World Warrior. I didn't test this one out. Again, the bouncing on the screen that you see, I don't know if you see it, but definitely my Elgato, possibly. I don't see that on my actual monitor here. But the Street Fighters that I've been playing on the videos that you see, the fireball, like the fire follows people. Let's see if I can throw a Hadouken. This one looks like a regular version of Street Fighter, that's fine. Okay, great. And yes, we did get one hand that I've done down on videos. The other ones, like I said, I was playing with was like fireball would follow the fighter. Easy stuff. Okay. It said there's your review of the Pandora's Box 3D. Do I think it's worth it? I'll be honest, hell yeah. Just for the fact that you could be playing PSP games, it's mind-boggling. Again, it's not a real Pandora's box. This one's called Pandora Game. I should name the title Pandora Game. I will do that. But hey, this is working, and I would buy it again, especially with the person that told me that the home edition does have the option to enable Wi-Fi to download more games. That might blew my mind. I don't have that on this specifically. Real quick before we end it, I'm gonna set this to coin play, as I just want to see what does the screen look like if we're on coin play. So it says insert coin. Does it bounce after like 10 seconds? Does it go to another game? Because that's the only one thing that kind of sucks. So right now with coin mode, I can't go up and down. Oh, it did something. Okay. It just switched screens. That's interesting. Let's let it go for a couple more seconds. Just got a text. Eugene is on the stream. Checking out your system, Eugene. I'm going to load up real quick my YouTube stream. Because again, on my Elgato, I do see the video bouncing. But it is not bouncing on my monitor. So. So as of right now, okay, it went into the all mode, which is great. And is it going down the list? Because I was looking at my phone. Yeah, it is going down the list. So awesome. As far as the attract mode on it, there is no sound on the attract mode, but at least it's actually going through the games. I installed like a Pandora's Box 9 on the cabinet once. And it didn't do a track mode, which kind of sucked. If I insert a coin, I am able to move around. That is awesome. Real quick, actually, I wanted to show you guys. We're going to go back into test mode. We're going to put this back for Eugene for free play. He literally, on the jam board, I opened up the control deck. We're going to set this to free play. And I did want to show you the key settings. So check it out. Gamepad settings, interesting. Again, I believe you could plug in USBs, but if I press player to start is good, but the coin, it does pause. Okay. Start coin. Oh, see that? My player one coin, it like lets you choose the D-pad / left stick. So if you wanted to switch the sticks, again, as you can see, all of our buttons do work, A, B, C, D, E, F. All of my joystick buttons work. I didn't put the home button because I didn't really, there was no home button. But as you can see, like player two coin is doing two button presses. That's just how it is in the JAMA harness. Player one plus A. I'm not going to redefine the keys. I don't want to screw anything up. Let's try the scan lines real quick. I guess some people want to see that. And we could check out the burst setting. Yeah, let's see it. Let's go back. Let's load up real quick. So I'm going to try to use this to my settings. So if I want to look up Galaga, I'm going to go G-A-L-A. Got a couple of Galagas. I just want to play the regular Galaga. And there's our scan line. Okay. Let's just see if I hold down button one, does it multi-fire? Nope. It does not. I mean, the scan lines are cool. But again, as you can see, we are playing a vertical game. Let's exit out. Let's real quick. I do want to... The recents list is very useful. Can't lie. Let's load up World Warrior real quick. Eugene is excited because we found a regular version of Street Fighter. I mean, the scan lines are cool. It's supposed to give you that CRT look. Me personally, I'm not a fan. There are different scanline options, like on a red. Raspberry Pi build or on a PC build, but this is just too... It's too many scam lines in my opinion. But you did want to enable it, literally switch on the actual board itself. I do like the little, like, transitions. The burst setting, I'm going to disable it. I'm going to put this back to HD. I'm guessing that's the 16:9 stretch. If I leave it to disabled, let's go back into Street Fighter. Let's see, is it a non-16:9 mode right now? No, they had 16:9. So I'm going to go back, bring that back to... And actually, one more thing I want to do before we go. I'm going to enable the coin, exit out. I'm going to go back into Street Fighter with my one coin. This will automatically add the coin. Like, this should... Yeah, right. This adds the coin. It actually added two coins. So as you can see, if you were trying to do this for retail or actual coin, it makes it as a... Two coins, I guess. But at least we know that. If I exit out, which I can't actually. Interesting. Oh no, I had to declare one coin and start. Interesting. I can't exit out now. With coin mode enabled, it says start and select. Go back into the menu. Exit mode is start and coin. I did that. Long press menu. Long press menu. Let's see. Let's try that real quick. Enter a coin. Usually, yes. Okay, so I could do... I'd rather do that. You hold down button one, and it will let you bring up the menu and then exit the game. So that's usually what I've seen it as. But... You lose your coin. So deal with it. That's it. That's honestly it, guys. Again, the Pandora's Game 3D. Would I recommend it? Hell yeah. For what this is giving you. 2,300 games. Arcade games. You got Game Boy games. You got your PlayStation games. PSP. And it mostly aims for like fighting games. Which I think is really what you want inside of an arcade cabinet. I would definitely recommend this 100%. The one thing I did learn is that you do need the correct power supply. In the beginning of Eugene's video, we couldn't get it to work. We had the wrong power supply. We were giving too much power. But now with the right power supply, it worked. In the description, I will add where we got this from. The name of the company is Pandora's Toy Box. Great stuff. They answered our emails as far as help with the power supply and all that. So on that note, guys. VicBP, Game Case Arcade, the Pandora Game 3D. I recommend it.